Hi everyone. As engineers, we do a lot of technical work. Ultimately, we do that work to change something in the world. And for something to change, someone needs to act. So this is a communication framework for you to use so you can turn your information into action. The goals of this screencast are so that you can provide the most value to your audience when you prepare a written document or a presentation, to present your work in a way that encourages other people to act and convey your thought processes so that the audience will understand how you got to your conclusion and what it means. Our process is going to start off with having a description, and in that description we're going to be looking to convey information, which might be, for example, our experimental results or the results of a calculation we've done. Then we move on to our analysis. And the analysis is going to comment on that information or a result. It's going to say, is this information good or bad? Is it useful? Is it relevant? It's going to perform some analysis on that information. Once we have that, we're going to move on to our critical thinking part. In this critical thinking part, what we're going to do is place our results or information in the context of other results or information, either from other calculations we've done or from examples we've found in the literature or in industry practice or in technical reports. Here we might talk about the significance of our information, the implications of our information, or the fundamentals that we can use to understand our information and why we've ended up getting it. Once we're finished with our critical thinking, we're going to move on to a conclusion. Our conclusion, we're going to come up with a decision, hopefully, that we've made about from the information and some key points. So what we're trying to convey there is what should be done and why it should be done. Lastly, we are going to say what action should be taken now that we know this conclusion. So what action should we be doing, who should be doing it, and when should they be doing it? So the game here is to try and make it as easy as possible for the user of this information to take action with it. So let's apply our thinking to an example. And the example I'm going to use is a pretty non-technical one, which will be an incident report on a toxic gas leak. So we're going to start off with our description, maybe some results or information that our investigations turned up. So in our description, we've come up with some information and results. We've identified that valve 241 was opened, the line pressure was reduced, the toxic gas was hydrogen sulfide, and the hydrogen sulfide concentration was 1,000 parts per million. So we've provided this information, and the next question someone reading our report would ask would be, so what? What does this information mean? So that's when we move on to our analysis phase. In our analysis phase, we're going to be considering the information and results that we've presented and saying if they're good or bad, useful or relevant. So let's pop back up and do that. We could say that valve 241 being opened was a bad thing because it let the hydrogen sulfide escape. But we could also say that it was a good thing because it reduced the line pressure. With the line pressure being reduced, we can say that that is a good thing because it stopped the line from overpressurizing and having a catastrophic release, let's say. The toxic gas being hydrogen sulfide, we can say that's a relevant piece of information because it's going to let us assess how dangerous the situation was. And same goes for knowing the hydrogen sulfide concentration that was reached in the room, that it was 1,000 ppm. It's also going to be useful information, relevant information for us because it allows us to quantify how dangerous the situation was. All right, so now we've done a little bit of analysis, we can move on to the critical thinking section. So for some critical analysis, let's take the hydrogen sulfide concentration of 1,000 ppm as an example. To put that into context, we can get some information from the literature and find out that a hydrogen sulfide concentration of between 500 and 1,000 ppm is instantly fatal. And so the significance of that and its implications are that anyone working in that space would have been killed. We could apply critical thinking to the other components, but for the brevity of time, I will leave it there with hydrogen sulfide. Let's say we've come up with three potential solutions of controlling the area, having an automatic shutoff, and having ventilation. We can then apply our process to them as well. So we can analyze these pieces of information and do some critical thinking about which one would be the best solution. Once we reach a decision, we'll provide that information and our conclusion. Let's say for our conclusion, we've decided that the automatic shutoff is going to be the best solution. We want to explain that and explain why we've chosen that. And then finally, we want to provide a future action, which in this case, we want to say who should do what and when. Let's say there should be an installation of the automatic shutoff, that the line engineer should be the person installing it, and that it should be completed by the 10th of October, 2022. So hopefully this framework is one you can use for your own results, starting out with the description, then into the analysis, your critical thinking, your conclusion, and what action should be taken. Good luck.